Previously on Dust and Elysian Tail. I'd say you're done, son. You're done, son. Defused. The lights. Now back to Furry Town. Hey, howdy, hello, and welcome back to some more Dust and Elysian Tail. When we last left off, we went down to another village, and we fought a guy named Fuse who set the whole place afire, and then we went to go talk to Jinder and found out that Dust might be working for the guy who's behind all this whole war thing. And that's my half-ass summary. Alright, so now we're gonna go, and there was a big explosion, and now we're gonna go see what the hell that was. Because it's taken us 5 episodes to kind of progress this story outside of just random quest. Are you still itchy?
Go for it! Go!
Are you still itchy? That would be awesome if he just left like that the whole game.
You really ought to be better equipped in case anything else comes through here.
Nonsense. I crafted this spear myself.
Yes, it's very nice.
All right, that's enough. Why don't you two leave me alone now?
All right. Wasn't there a big explosion? Where would it be? I could've sworn it was something. Over here. Is it over there by the mayor? I'm gonna be so dumb if it is. Okay, Jinder was standing right there, were we? If it's not over there by the mayor, I'm gonna check. Mayor?
Thank you, Dust.
Okay, it's not. I guess this is where we're going. I don't know. Fuck it. Oh. Oh, yeah. How do you change that again? Okay, it was this one. Okay, all right, let's... Guess we're not going to the hidden gate. I don't fucking know where the fuck I'm supposed to go. You smell that? It smells like a jump cut. Wait a minute. The hell? I don't think I've been down here before.
Well now, if you look at this. Seems our village has got itself a new basement.
You don't seem too concerned.
Trust me, not much happens here. So when things start crawling out of the ground, you pull up a chair and enjoy the show.
Okay, Augustine, but promise me that you'll stay here. I don't need anyone getting hurt.
Bah! Let you have all the fun? Well, I guess you're the one with the sword after all.
Okay.
What's all this?
These flags are a warning. The area up ahead is among the most dangerous of places. The challenges and creatures within are unlike anything you've dealt with before. Death will come swiftly if you are not prepared.
I think I've heard of these arenas. It's rumored they contain precious treasures.
Hey, your memory's coming back.
Just little bits here and there. Think we should go in?
Oh, I certainly hope you stay.
Oh my god, I love fidgets, like fourth wall breaking. Sure, huh? Check your scar. Jesus! Ow. Burn. They look like me. They look like monsters I've fought before. Just a different color palette. Oh, we're being timed. Oh, we got a time limit. Go. Let's see. A wet suit. Okay. That's you, bro. Wait, is there anything else down here? Oh, I don't know.
Please, Dust, go there and see if she's safe. I'll be following, but I'm...
If you insist on coming...
When Dust starts swinging that sword, you don't want to be anywhere near him. Have you seen the scream? He just goes...
Have you seen the... Oh. Okay, that was... Let's see. Can I accomplish anything? Oh, we're under. Run out of time. Okay, that's the most important one. I guess the purple one is the most important one, right? Okay, is there anything else down here that I can... get a good look at? Okay, I can go this way now. Okay. The other way was optional.
End of the line. Looks like a pretty nasty drop.
Yes, very nasty. We should go around, I think.
There's no time to find another route. Those monsters came up through here. There's gotta be a path down below. Well, here goes nothing.
Okay. How did you live through that dust? Oh, I don't have a redstone.
Did you see something move up ahead? I saw something move.
Fidget, you need to calm down. I thought you said you weren't afraid of the dark.
I'm not afraid of the dark. I'm afraid of the things in the dark.
I don't see anything, Fidget.
How could you possibly see anything in here with that big hat over your eyes? I hate leaves. Our kind isn't meant to be underground. We should be soaring high in the wide open sky.
I thought you were afraid of heights.
Oh, hush.
Alright. Oh, it's like, it's a thing that was that attacked us in... Gets me off guard every time. Oh! Well, fine. I love how we're already, like, six episodes. This is episode six. We're just now in chapter two. I probably should start making these episodes a little longer. Or at least do something productive. I was getting a feel for it. I know what I'm doing now. Jeez. Oh. I. Just love ripping through everything. Can you, like, hear my PS4 up there? I say up there because it's on a shelf above my head. Not right above my head. That would be dangerous. My Xbox One is right above my head. Finally, we're done with the oldest quest in my shit. Let's just keep going. Oh! I really want to know what y'all would do if y'all saw some shit like this in real life. Oh, that would be... I think I would piss myself.
have slain the one known as Fuse.
I had no choice. He'd lost his minds, murdered many innocents.
I am not judging, friend. His death was sad, but necessary.
Forgive me for asking, but are you a Moonblood?
The Moonbloods. They are an ancient race, and their presence is not tolerated in these lands. One would be at a disadvantage among so many warm-blooded creatures.
I understand.
I believe you do not, my friend. But I will not press the matter if you do not.
Is this the same dude? Tell you what, how about I buy some treasure? How about I buy all your treasure keys? How about I buy one of your treasure keys?
Your transaction is most appreciated.
And we just forget that I even ever asked. Dang, it's really loud up there. I need to clean it. Like it's getting up. Probably got a lot of dust in there. I don't need to eat it. Oh, wait, beat, I gotta do the beat. Okay, that was horrible, Dust. You can do better than that. I'm just going down as far as I can go. God dang it. Controls are so damn slippery. I mean, it moves fine. Ow, what the fuck? Oh, please don't tell me somebody. It got into that thing and I just tried to slip it out. What am I doing? What the fuck you doing? Okay, there we go. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Oh boy.
Wait.
What?
This creature is too well defended for a straightforward assault.
We'll see about that. Okay, that was a bad idea.
It is practically invulnerable unless you stun it with a parry, like so.
Wait, what? Oh, thank you for literally guiding his body. Oh, please.
Attack and hold X at the moment of the enemy strike, and you will parry their move.
Oh.
Counterattack.
Oh.
Timing is crucial, and you must be facing your opponent. A successful parry may daze your opponent, and will fully restore your energy meter. You will be unable to harm certain enemies unless they are dazed. This is one such creature. Exercise patience and observe your opponent's pattern, and you will emerge victorious.
All right. Wait, it said X. It said X, didn't it? I could have sworn. Did I just kill it that easily? Whatever. It said X, though. And it was talking about square. Oh, hey.
Whoa, what was that?
I'm not sure, but it sure did run off in a hurry.
All right. I appreciate you all waiting for me. Right. Says I can go this way. Nope. No, I can't. There are times where I can damn now fly with this thing, and there are some times I just fucking can't.
Wait.
He dropped it.
Let's follow him.
Let's not eat it. Up or down, damn it. Hello again.
I am here to support. Your transaction is... Thank you.
So apparently the thing's called Moonbloods. Or like lizards? Lizards like... Take that. try out fire. Oh my god. There we go. What is that?
There he goes.
Forget him. Take a look around. There's something horribly wrong with these mushrooms.
These aren't mushrooms, Fidget. They are called bubble sprouts, and it would be wise for us to tread lightly around them. They react rather explosively to movement.
Wonderful.
Hey, just take it easy. Now, dude, exactly what the fuck does tread lightly mean? Because I don't think you can just walk, right? Hello again. I can always tell when the save point's nearby.
Later.
Oh, they are real cool. Wait a minute. Hold on. Oh my god, no. Alright, that was actually pretty hard. That wasn't hard at all.
And there he goes again. You're welcome, kid.
Come now, Dust. He's obviously terrifying. Let's go find him, and maybe get out of this raining death.
Up. Oh. Mud pit. Mud pot.
I didn't think those monsters were smart enough to build a fence.
I'm certain they didn't. Let's hop on over.
Okay, I'm sorry.
There he is!
Your father's done gonna have himself a heart attack after he hears about this.
I'm sorry, Mama.
Goodness, what would I do if you've gotten yourself hurt? They jump my fence! Crafty vermin, those surface dwellers!
She does see that I can fly, right?
I'll be sure to tell her, Fidget. I'm sure that'll clear things right up.
Back! Back, you beast! I got this ear spoon and I ain't afraid to use it!
We aren't here for trouble, ma'am. In fact, we just saved your son.
What are they talking about, Bobo?
Well, they have been following me for a while.
What? How far out did you go? I may just save the spoon for you.
I'm sorry. We just came down from the surface to...
Do I look like some country bumpkin to you? Of course you're from the surface. I think I'd remember seeing a talking, flying weasel cat thing down here.
I think we got off on the wrong foot here. My name's Dust, and this is Fidget. Some creatures attacked a village above these caves, and we're trying to figure out why.
Attacked a surface village, you say? Well, if that don't beat all, we underground folk tend to keep to ourselves. Got enough problems of our own already.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Actually, what I'm saying is, we got enough problems of our own without you surface folk bringing all that nonsense down here. So, if you don't mind...
Come on, Dust. We're obviously not wanted here. Wait!
That's enough, Bobo! You ought to get back to your chores before I take out the spoon again!
Mama, I've seen them fight! They even got themselves a talking sword! I bet they could help!
Young man, I don't care if their sword spouts rainbows and bowls of delicious baked beans. I don't want their help!
Stop saying that! Pa's gonna die if we don't do something!
Die? What's going on?
Well, our healing wells have gone and run dry. And my pa's done gotten real sick. That's why I went out! To find some more of that water.
I hate saying it, but it's true. See these mud pots lying around? Normally they're bubbling to the brim with mineral water. But just a few weeks ago, they dried up to nothing.
But that still don't excuse you from putting yourself in danger like that! I may not be able to help your father, but I sure as heck ain't gonna lose you too!
Mama!
I wonder if those monster attacks on the surface could be related to your wells drying up.
I wouldn't be at all surprised. It's been a couple weeks since the water dried up, but every creature here is feeling the effects. I'll bet those creatures broke through to the surface looking for more water.
Mama! Maybe these two can go talk to the lady.
The lady?
Oh, it's a lady.
Sweet old soul. Lives deep in the caves. Makes the waters flow. She doesn't show herself around here too often. And we can't actually go see her on account of all the nasties living between here and there.
In that case, I'll go speak with this lady and see why she stops the flow of water.
You do that?
This can't all just be a coincidence. The attacks on the surface, your wells drying up... I'm certain this lady must know something about what's going on.
Well then, I had you folks pegged all wrong. If you
went yes,
to
help
my husband, I promise not to clock you with my wooden spoon of justice.
Oh, justice.
Thanks.
So, you're heading down to talk to the lady now? You'll help my paw?
Fuck.
Just don't go running off again.
You got my
I need a new chair. I'll talk to him. I don't need no more quests. Do I go down or up? I'm assuming I go down. Oh, we cannot go. I'm assuming we gotta go up because there's. I assume like the stones are optional though.
Oh,
You know what? I'm going to go ahead and end it here, guys. You know, like, subscribe, comment, and all that. If it's your birthday today, happy freaking birthday. And I'll see you next time. Peace.